Hello guys, I am Matteo from Andor Games and I am happy to welcome you to the Chef tutorial. During this series of episodes I'll show you how to approach this kind of figure with my personal method and I'll show you how to reach a very good quality results in very few steps. Hello guys and welcome to my The Chef tutorial. In this episode I will show you my techniques and philosophy behind my style and miniature painting approach. I will show you my brushes, favorite brushes, sort of my tools, airbrush and colors, my way to approach techniques and my personal way to create palette. Okay guys, today we approach the chef and we start to paint considering a lot of important stuff like composition, palette composition, lights and shadows. For this character I changed the miniature a bit, I removed the cigar to give a different look from the original box art and probably we will paint the tentacles with a lobster style and we'll repeat some elements of this lobster food truck on its clothes. For example, a freehand with a nice cyberpunk style lobster or a black hat to create the position of his food truck. And to paint, we will compose our palette in a very dark mood to create something of dirty or dark ambience. I will show you also my approach for lights and shadows. And probably we will create a directional light to create more atmosphere on his story. I'll show you also my approach to lights and shadows and we will create a directional light on the minis to push up the dark ambience of this character in his truck. So probably we create a very strong contrast between shadows and lights and we will approach the miniature in a 2D way to create a lot of storytelling about this character. Okay guys, I won't spend some words about brushes. In my opinion it's not very important the brand of brushes. Here we have Broken Toad, Da Vinci, Tintoretto and they are all high quality brushes, so it doesn't matter which kind of brands are you using if you choose a high quality brush. The most important part of a brush for my opinion is the point and is the size of the point. Usually I paint most of my figure with a huge number 3 or 2 because I love the capacity of the brushes to keep a lot of colors. In this way I am able to paint a lot of time without take colors from the palette. To refine usually I paint with a 0 or a double 0 but this is not so much important. I think that the most important part is to find the most comfortable paint, the most comfortable brush for you. My favorite brush is the flat brush. I love this kind of brush because it gives me the possibility to realize a lot of sketch and I will show you how to use this kind of brushes. Okay, now we got our brushes and our miniature, the chef from Mindwork Games. Now we go to spend some words about my wet palette composition. Hello guys, and back to this tutorial. In this section I'll explain you my color choice. I need to make an important disclaimer about colors. I think that it's not very important to use a very specific line or brands of color. You need to use the color that give you the possibility to paint in a comfortable way. So in my opinion, all the brands are allowed. These are some of my favorite colors, and I usually spend a lot of time before painting just to create the concept of my miniature. And I spend time, look at my colors, look at my inks, to starting to create my palette. In this case, I choose the two kind of color. Color, for example, from Chimera Model or AK, that are colors made for modellers. These colors are matte and give you the possibility to cover very well the miniature and to build up all the construction that you need to create shadows or lights. On the other side, we got fine art colors. These heavy body colors give me the possibility to play more with tones, more with transparencies, and to create something that is different by this kind of color. It's different because their pigments are different and give you the possibility to create differences in tones or playing more with contrast. For example, usually I put on my palette a lot of them. I put some yellow, some red, some blue, some green. In this case, I just put on my palette to have them ready to use. I don't know if I use them or when I will use them, but for me it's important to have all the color on my palette. Probably then I'll add also more colors on my palette, colors that are not involved in my mental process. But for a personal use, I prefer to have them on the palette. This is because I am a bit lazy. During painting process, I prefer to have all the color placed in the palette. In this way, I don't lose time to stop to painting for looking a new color, to choose a new brand. Everything is on the palette. The palette gives me the possibility to create all the colors I need. So, let's go to create the palette for the chef. Okay guys, now I explain and show you my way to create palette. For me, palette is very important step on my painting process. The palette gives me the possibility to create during the process. My process is never scheduled before. I start to paint with intuition, with feelings, and palettes needs to give me the possibility to play with colors. For this reason, I suggest to put a lot of color on palette. Sometimes I see some modellers just drop little drops of colors on palette and then spend a lot of time to keep track of the bottles and add every time more color on the palette. In this way you don't have the control and the palette don't give you the possibility to play with colors. So for example, let's start with the main base color that we will use for the skin tone. I chose this color because it's a matte and is a medium tone that give me the possibility to play. This is a boost and the skin tone is a very important element. So I spend a lot of time on the skin tone and this will be one of the main color for this element, for this character. So I put a lot of color in the middle of the palette. I prefer to put a lot of color on palette, in this way I can create a lot of tone variation all around my main color. So I'll proceed to add a bit of color for the other elements. We will bring a bit of red, turquoise, I highly suggest you to not focus on the brands. I'm using Chimera, but you can use scale 75 or whatever you want. Black. and white. On the other side, I had some tones a bit more desaturated, like for example an ivory. This is a green gray for a K, but common ivory could be okay. Some extra colors, for example this like this black red, I think that could be a good choice to create a dark skin tone, because we talked about a dark environment for our chef. I add also a bit of wine red, just to give me the possibility to play with the different red. I will use red and turquoise to create contrast. I'll push the red into orange direction to create contrast with a turquoise with very deep bluish shadows. On the other side of the palette, I'll put all my artistic fine art color. When I choose this color, there is no schedule behind the choice. I try to put some primary color or some color that I like so much. For example, this is a red iron oxide, perylene violet, yellow iron oxide, permanent alizarin crimson, sap green, Naples yellow, that is a color that I love so much, and phthalo turquoise. Also in this case, don't be shy to put your colors on the palette, especially if you are using a wet palette, because you don't waste any kind of color. You can paint with the same palette for days and days. This kind of heavy body colors give you the possibility to play with consistency. With consistency you are being able to create also variation on thickness on the surface of the miniature that will increase the contrast between more desaturated part or more saturated components. I keep a free space between the two kind of color to create all the mix that I need. Sometimes I start to create a bit of mixes before to start to paint. For example, I usually start to create some variation for with my main base color, in this case the skin tone. There is no specific reason why I'm doing this. I just need to try to understand all the tones that I will use, or also to discover some new tones, new specific tones to create my environment. We said that we can do something, we will do something of dark. So probably I'll add a bit of blue to the skin tone. And we will paint something of turquoise for his clothes. So in this way we start to create a bit of harmony, including the turquoise into the shadows of the skin tone. I try to add the colors of each elements of the miniature inside the recipe for the other elements. In this way we can keep a sort of muted and limited palette color that give us the possibility to create something very well harmonized. On the other side, I can start to create a bit of lights. For example, we could add a bit of yellow. A bit of ivory. Or white for the max lights. I avoid to use pure white because I prefer keep everything a bit desaturated, especially on this character, because we will create something of darker. Okay, my first step on the palette is done. I got my main shadows, main color and lights for the skin tone, and during the process probably we will start to add more colors to create a variation on tones. Let's go.
Matteo, could you give us more information about paint dilution?
Of course. I prefer to keep my colors not diluted in the palette, because we have the wet palette, so we don't have fear about to ruin the color. For example, I prefer to keep the color thick to create also thickness on the figure. In this way I can place a lot of colors and use the color pure. At the same time I have a lot of space to keep, take a bit of color, put here and create my glazing or something similar. Usually I don't paint with glazes, I paint with wet blending or putting a lot of color directly on the miniature. To create this kind of technique or process, you need to have thick color and not diluted. Okay guys, at this point we got our brushes, we got our miniature and our colors, so let's go and have fun for the process.